Happy Sabbath, church. Thank God we've entered into the holy hours. Amen. From evening to the next evening, the hours are holy. 24 hours. Amen. We are practicing what we do in heaven. The other day we started that in the new heaven and in the new earth, all flesh will bow before the Lord when? From one moon to another and one Sabbath to another. So we practice Sabbath keeping down here so that we may fit up there. Amen. I want to thank God for all our friends who have come for the first time. God bless you. The Bible says there are some people who are called the last-minute workers. Remember the parable? Mm-hmm. There are those who went into the master's vineyard early in the morning until sundown, and some guys came the last minute. And when the master was giving wages, he began with those who came early. 5 hours, 6 hours, 10 hours in the vineyard, he gave them what was called a denarii, okay? Or let's say a rand or a dollar. Beginning with those who came early. Are you with me? Then the guys who came, I did the opposite, right? Yeah. Those who came late, he gave them a dollar or a denarii. And the guys who came and spent 6 hours, they said, look, simple mathematics. If the guys who worked an hour get a dollar, therefore we who worked 10 hours, it means 10. Then he gave those who came and spent 10 hours in the field a dollar. And they were angry. They say, how come you're equating us with those who spent 1 hour? And the Lord said, look, I do what I want with my money. The denarii or the dollar is eternal life. He who came early and spent the whole week here, and he who managed to come today, when all are saved, they will be given one denarii, which is eternal life. Amen. Amen. So God is fair. Amen. Amen. Very good. Tonight is a great night. Our topic is even great. What does it say, please, on your screen? The mother of all weddings. I've heard of weddings. Prince Charles and his wife and other guys have done what people call great, but their weddings do not compare to the mother of all weddings. I'm going to ask the congregation to sit reverently. Is my pianist, where is he? Play very softly as we respect the groom and the bride as they come. Play on, sir. Reverently, please. No talking. No talking. The mother of all weddings. I see people telling this side. And then decide, expecting somebody to come in. Yes, we're waiting for the groom to come in. No laughing, please. Reverence. If I run out of chairs, my ushers will quickly add more chairs. What does the church say?
Amen.
Behold, the groom comes. He's coming to fetch his bride. As the bride enters, ladies and gentlemen, we shall all stand up in reverence, please. Each man receives his wife. No laughing, please. The ushers direct my right, beautiful. Take your seats there. Come this side, please. The bride and the groom in the center. Okay. It's all right. Thank you.
you to be stopped.
Okay. What does the church say?
Amen.
Yes. We shall sing our song, the first and the last stanza, our theme song. Let it be displayed. Let's sing it loud, please. And they're beautiful up here. Love at home. And then they ask the party to look at the people. When you finish the song, you
look at
Adam and Eve, the first couple on earth. Today it's Sabbath. Amen?
Amen?
Sabbath and holy marriage are connected. Both are holy. May I say something to you? I am not a marriage officer. So what you see here is just dramatization. Just somebody says, oh, he was. No, I'm not a marriage officer. It's just a good illustration. These are couples. Okay, this is a couple, right? I've asked friends to accompany so that the drama comes out well. Amen. It's not a marriage ceremony, please. Okay, it's an illustration. I have a few hints to give to young people. I and my wife wedded in 1995. Amen. 1995. And I'll tell you the steps we followed here for the benefit of young people. Are you the young people?
Yes.
Yes. Preparing for a wedding is a very taxing thing. It needs one to do great strategic planning. You don't just wed, you plan. Amen?
Amen.
The groom has to pay the bride price to his in-laws. Correct? The groom has to what?
Pay
the bride price to his in-laws and then get their nod that he may go ahead and prepare for the wedding before they hand over their daughter. I'm talking about how it is done in the Christian way. Okay, you pay the bola, or you pay the bride price, you get the blessings or the nod of the in-laws for the next step. Christian wedding. I'm not talking about other weddings. In fact, I'm talking about Adventist weddings. And after paying the bride price, the groom goes to make thorough preparations for the great day. And the bride too starts serious preparations for the great day. Are you with me? There's much preparation there, both sides, the groom and the bride. Friends and relatives are invited, wedding invitations, they are invited to come and witness the union of the great of the marriage parties. Invitations are sent around. The daughter will then be officially handed over to the groom publicly on the wedding day before many witnesses. I'm talking how it is done according to the Bible. Amen. There are many ways that people are doing it. I'm talking about holy matrimony. Young people, are you listening how it is done? It's a bit of an education in the next 3 or so minutes. It says, now the gospel minister officiates on behalf of God. Because God is the one who officiated in the first wedding. Adam and Eve. He has now appointed gospel ministers who are qualified to stand in his place, that they may pronounce a divine blessing upon the parties. Are you with me? That is why you see gospel ministers featuring when there's a holy wedding. They are standing
in place of God.
Sorry. I think the devil didn't want you to hear that. Okay, the minister of the gospel stands in the place of God. Since God is the author of holy marriage, Genesis 1 tells you of how Genesis 2. Sorry, I didn't know how to switch off this thing. The devil is disturbing us today. Please just. Okay, Adam and Eve were united by God in holy matrimony, and that tradition continues to this very day. God, being represented by his ministers and the parties, receive a divine blessing. Thereafter, the couple is pronounced his husband and young people, what do you say?
Amen.
Behold, the steps have been outlined. Pay the bride price. Amen. So living with her without paying is not godly. Nobody says amen. People in Satan are very angry. Pay the bride price. Get the blessing of the in-laws. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Get the blessing of the in-laws. Amen.
Amen.
And then men go and prepare. And the group, the bride also prepares for the day. Call witnesses. Don't wed the two of you alone. It's not a wedding. Wherever there is a divine wedding, there must be a minister of the gospel.
Amen.
Standing in the place of God to pronounce a blessing upon you. Are you with me? Now to enter without the divine blessing will cost you. Amen. I'm tracing it from the word of God. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the mother of all weddings. I am talking about the wedding of Jesus Christ. When we are told marriage is holy, it is because it points to Christ. Are you with me? I want to check if Christ paid the bride price. And I will show you if Christ, after paying the price, has he gone to prepare? I'm going to, all these steps I've outlined to you, you will see them in the Bible. so that you retrace your steps. Those who are already living together or married, you can't get out now. God winks at your mistakes, but at your level, He gives you another chance. You can call for a holy wedding, though you are married. Did you know that? Because what you need in your house is the divine blessing. A minister of the gospel has to stand in the place of God and pronounce a blessing upon. God bless the couple. If it is your pleasure that you give them children, bless them too. Are you with me? Whatever they do, Lord, give them joy. He has to pronounce that. Amen. So if you went to live together without this pronunciation, thank God you are here tonight. He will give you a second chance. Even if you are 50, 60, 70, you never received the divine blessing, you can still wait. Are you with me? If proper arrangements are made. Sister, He hasn't paid the price for you. How dare you offer yourself that He lives with you? Insist on a holy wedding. Sister, insist. Amen. Amen. Insist on a holy wedding. Because you need the blessing of God. Christ paid the bride price on Calvary. Matthew chapter 27, verse 35. And they crucified Him and parted His garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet. They parted My garments among them, and upon My vesture they did cast lots. Jesus Christ, the groom, because of love, amen, came from heaven, and the price He had to pay for His bride, the church, I would get, is a price that no one of us can pay. Are we together? So Jesus paid the price at Calvary. He paid with His own life. He gave up His throne at the right hand of God. Are you with me? And He humbled Himself and became like a servant for you and for me and for His church. Are you with me? His marriage did not require silver and gold. The payment He had to pay was not cows and goats. What was required was His blood. Because of His love, He paid. When He saw your face, and your face, and your face, and your face here, in mine, He said, My love for them is stronger than death. And He paid. There's a man who's living with somebody, and he's not paid. Cows, not his life. The in-laws just need goats. He can pay. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loves the church. There are those who have pretended to pay bride price to their in-laws, but they owe their in-laws, they have a balance there. Jesus paid it. Oh, God help us as men to pay all. Don't use somebody's daughter when you have not even paid. Our sisters are not so cheap, man. You are worth the payment. Amen. Young lady, don't be so cheap. Look at Christ. He paid. That guy must pay. And pay it all. He became poor, the Bible says. He became poor for us, that we might be rich. I heard a guy complaining when they charge him 200,000 rand. He weeps and wails. Jesus paid it all, and He became poor for us. Let me just tell you, friend, on the judgment day, if you are a man tonight, when your name comes up before the heavenly justice, you are going to be compared the way you treat your wife with Jesus the way he treats the church. If Jesus is using the church without pay, so you are justified. If the serious homework, stop going for those numerous holidays. Save money and pay up. Clear your balance. Come with your in-laws. The men are saved now. Cheer up, brother. Tonight is your night. God is talking to you and he's talking to me. Amen. Amen. If we do it the Jesus way, parents become happy. In-laws become happy. Because nobody's using their daughter for nothing. And whatever is done, parents are on both sides. They say, God bless you, my children. If parents are saying, where is she? Does anybody know where she is? She's living in Johannesburg. And you are living with him. That's an God. If any person is not found in heaven, it's nobody's fault but his. Light has come to St. John Church in the family week of prayer. Receive the light. Amen. Correct your wrongs. Amen. Be Jesus like. He paid the price. I don't have time to refer to many scriptures where Paul says he bought us with his own. He bought us. He paid. Not silver and gold, but with his own life. He gave up the luxuries to the point of poverty. So men, be willing to be poor for the one you have married and the one whom you want to marry. After paying the bride price, normally the groom goes to prepare. If things are done the Christian way, he goes to what? A place so that when the wife comes, she has a place to stay. Before I say many things, listen to the scripture. John 14, verse 1 to 3. The mother of all weddings. I see young people here, you listen carefully. Do it the Jesus way. You'll be blessed. Do shortcuts, young men. You'll be cutting short your life. Shortcuts, cut your life short. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. These are words like for people in courtship, you know what I'm saying? Or somebody just paid the bride price. It says, assuring now the loved one. Don't let your heart be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me. The group is saying, I am trustworthy. Trust me. I have already paid the bride. The next thing, we will wait. Amen. Amen. There are some men and some youngsters who are men of false promises. They keep people waiting several years and then dump them. Jesus came to mend hearts. You are busy breaking hearts. There's a great day coming when every man will give an account of what he has done. I've heard of the Antichrist, the chief Antichrist, you know him. But there are little Antichrists. When Christ mends hearts, their business is to break hearts. I know some people who have left church because they were made to wait 7 years by a fair gentleman, handsome, but a terrible heart. Ellen White says, in the Adventist home, I think, a man with ugly facial features is better than a handsome thief. Was she referring to you? A man of broken promises. There are hearts that are crying. Hearts that have been wounded and broken by a man who is ungodly. Tonight is your night. Ask God for a second chance. Because you are guilty before the judgment bow of God. Amen? Amen. Let not your heart be troubled. In every relationship, there is need of assurance. Married couples, if I ask your wife, how many times did you kiss it today? You'll say, you know, I love you, I married you. You need to assure every day. Is somebody listening to me?
Amen.
Women, if I'm speaking the truth, raise your hands and say amen.
Amen.
You need assurance every day.
Amen.
So raise your hand high. Men, lift up your eyes, see those hands, hands up. Assurance every day. Don't say, look, I told you 15 years ago that time. Why should I keep telling you that I love you? Are you with me? God gives you assurance every day that He loves you. So men, love your wives as God, Christ loves them. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Every successful relationship is God at its center. So here Christ refers the lady to God. Believe in God. And also in, I am trustworthy. There are some gentlemen who are doubted by their wives. She doesn't trust you because you have lost the character of God in your life. Godly men are trustworthy. Godly youngsters in courtship are trustworthy. Are you with me?
Amen.
They are young persons of one girlfriend. If you start having 5, 6, 7, 8 at your age, I'm telling you. I'm talking about the Christian context. Don't mistake me. Christian emphasis. Adventist lifestyle. Amen. I've got to prepare a place for you. It says, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in? In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. And I go to prepare a place for? Jesus gives us an example. I have paid the bride price. The next thing I have to prepare a place for? Young people, don't marry when you stay in your Father's house. Prepare a place for her. Nobody says it. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother. Are you with me? One kitchen is not big enough for two women. They will fight and quarrel about order and washing dishes there. Is somebody listening? Prepare a place for her. A woman wants her own kitchen, her own house. Are you with me? Not to put her under somebody's roof. Are you with me? Young men, if they have not prepared a place, don't marry. Stop even proposing. You're not ready. Is somebody listening? Take it from Christ. He's preparing for His word. I'm going to prepare a place for you. Even birds, before they lay their eggs, they build a nest. Don't tell me a bird is wiser than you. We have no place. Here you are proposing. Mary, to bring into your father's house. That you may trouble your mother in her own kitchen. I'm going to prepare a place for you so that when I go and prepare a place, I will come again and receive you to myself. So after you pay, you go and prepare, then come for the wedding to receive her. Are you with me? Sister, if you are just received before a wedding, no preparation, no wedding. In fact, there are some ladies who propose to come before everything is ready. Sisters, be sober, be godly. Says, now if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. Jesus is coming up because He paid the bride price on Calvary. Are you with me? He paid it all. So he is coming again to receive his church. Amen. Amen. The church is not going to wait in vain. The groom, the bride, the church is waiting for the second coming of the groom. The waiting has been long, but she is waiting. Young ladies, don't say, my friend, we married at 25. I'm now 30. What will happen to me? And you start panicking. Though the wait may be long, the Lord will honor you. The groom will come. Don't be impatient. How long is the church waiting for the coming of the groom? But the Bible says, behold, he comes. Signs of the times, he comes. He says, believe in me. Trust me, I am coming. Wait for, so marriage is holy. Young lady, in courtship, if you are impatient, then you fail to represent the church of God. Are you with me? Men, if you are a liar, you make promises and don't come to get there, you are not a child. You are practicing the works of the Antichrist. Yes. Because Christ, when he promises, he comes back. How many broken promises here? Any man who has left church because of you, or any lady who has left church because of you, the Lord says, I need her blood upon you. Her soul will I require as thy hands. Men of lying lips and broken promises. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loves the church. I'm going to prepare a place for you. And the Bible says, behold, he comes. And when he comes, we saw the groom coming. Amen. And the lady coming. And friends and witnesses escorting. In these things that happen on earth, when we have holy weddings, they have divine meaning. Jesus is not coming alone to get her. The Bible says, behold, he comes with his Father's glory and with the glory of angels. 10,000 times 10,000. And the thousands of thousands are escorting the groom to come to get his wife. How dare you get here with no witnesses? Where did you learn this theology? Angels are witnesses, six-winged, four-winged, am I right? Two-winged, cherubims and seraphims, heaven will be emptied. I believe God alone remains on the throne. Everyone else escorts Christ as he comes to get his groom. So when you see the bride or team coming in, they represent angels. Was there a bride or team on your day? I don't talk about cohabitation. I don't even talk about cohabitation. According to the word of God, you yourself can see it doesn't fit anywhere in the divine plan. No witnesses. Secretive. Used, being used when nobody is paying for you. Dishonoring parents who do not know where their daughter is hibernating somewhere in Johannesburg. Whether upstairs or downstairs, or they don't know. Relatives who put a picture into the newspaper in missing person. Have you seen this face? Phone these numbers. And you expect to be the kingdom of my God. Forget it tonight. Tonight, forget it. Do it the Jesus way. Oh, he comes with pomp and glory. Hallelujah. Amen. The Bible says lightning jumps from the east, zigzags its way to the west, announcing the coming of the Holy Son of God, escorted by the bridal team. If I go, I will come again for you. Stand up, my sister. She represents the church. She represents the church. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loves the church, Ephesians 5. He loved the church that he gave himself for her, that he might purify and wash her clean with the word. That's what Ephesians 5 said. Clean with the word. Husband, love your wife as Christ loves the church. He gave himself to the point of poverty. He paid it all to wash her clean, not to infect her with STD diseases, with the viruses, gonorrhea, syphilis. Friend, where did you get this doctrine from? You may be seated, friends. Who said the Bible is boring? Who said there is no spirit in the Seventh-day Adventist Church? How then do we know the deep things of God if there is no spirit? The spirit in the Adventist Church is not to make people roll and fall. No. When the Spirit comes, He shall guide you into all truth. Divine oracles become so clear, as simple and clear as crystal. That's the work of the Holy Spirit. Not to make you jump and dance and drink funny waters. When you don't study the Bible, you shall be lost. The Adventist home, the Bible in every home. How can you go wrong? If you have sociology only and no Bible, psychology only and no Bible, how can your family be well? Philosophies of men will not help you. You need the sure word of God.
Amen.
Behold, he comes to receive his own. Jesus is waiting for the great day. He's going to prepare, amen, a place for his church. If you are a member of his church, I assure you, the husband of the church is going to prepare a mansion for you. For you, not for them, you. If there's an empty mansion up there, nobody's fault but yours. You say, Lord, how come this mansion is empty? You say, that gentleman is sent on, I prepared it for Mr. So-and-so. But he refused to give his heart and his life to me. But this was meant for him. Sorry, he did not make it. Are you with me? I am coming again. Jesus is coming again. Amen. Signs of the times abound. Nations rise against one another. Amen? The wife of Christ is happy. She's reading the signs. Amen? Wars and rumors of what? Outbreaks of diseases. Strange, incurable. Signs of the times is coming. The bride is getting happy and excited when everybody in the world is getting confused. Are you with me? Because she is in loving relationship with Christ. Her husband is coming soon. Amen?
Amen.
Let me move. What is Jesus going to prepare for his wife, the church? If every young man and every man here is listening, these are the steps you take when you want to marry. Amen? Prepare a place. Revelation 21 verse 2. Prepare a house, please, for her. John was shown in vision by the Lord in the book of Revelation the preparation that Jesus has made. And Paul said, the eye has not seen, nor the ear heard what the Lord has prepared for his church. The mother of all weddings. Revelation 21 verse 2 says, and I, John, saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down from God and out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I'm going to prepare a place for you. Believe in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. Jesus went to prepare a great city for his people. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
When he receives the church, we shall dwell in that city. Ah, let's read the details, man. When a man is preparing for the wedding, see how thorough, see how meticulous he is. After paying the bride price, he prepares. It's a great day in his life. Are you with me? Every man should prepare and copy Christ. Verse 10, Revelation 21 verse 10, I'm going to read fast. And he carried me away in the spirit, that the prophet John, to a great high mountain, and he showed me the great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending from heaven from God, having the glory of God. And her light was like unto a stone most precious, even like jasper, stone clear as crystal. Let not your heart be troubled. I'm going to prepare for you a place. So when Jesus paid the price, the bride price, he went to prepare a jasper city for his wife. What kind of a city did he prepare? City of jasper. Friend, you can't even prepare a house of bricks for her. You can't. God have mercy on us. Now let's read on what Jesus has prepared. City of jasper, verse 18. On the east of the city I saw three gates, and on the northern side three gates, to the south three gates, to the west three gates. So it has 12 entrance points for her. And the wall of the city, verse 14, they had 12 foundations, and in them the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. So the names of the 12 disciples are written. Okay? And he that talked with me, the angel, had a golden reed to measure the city, and the gates thereof, and the wall thereof. And the city lieth 4 square, the length as large as the breadth. And he measured the city with his reed 12,000 furlongs. The length and the breadth and the height of the city are equal. In the land of Fitness there, there is a city 4 square for you. Well measured, length equal to width equal to height. It's a cube for you. If you don't give your life to Jesus Christ, nobody's fault but yours. Paul and the other people saw, even Abraham, he was convinced that he was a sojourner in this world, because he was looking for a city whose builder and maker and engineer is God, is Jesus himself. They saw it by faith. Back then, we who are in the last days are blind to the city. You think it's way off when it's near. But the real children of God, the real remnant people of God, can see the city is near. They're getting ready for the mother of all weddings. There are some stingy men who will not spend a single dollar or rand on their wives, but are prepared to spend thousands on girlfriends. They will tell us on the judgment day where they learned this doctrine from. Here is Jesus lavishing for the benefit of his what? Bride. How dare you become selfish, man? When you earn your wages, you go into the toilet to budget alone. Counting there. We think the man is seeking there. No. Doesn't even trust his wife on financial matters. That's why it is a secret bank account, known to himself alone. The wife is not a signatory there. When he's sick and he has paralysis, when a signature is needed, nobody's trusted to sign. They bring the book in the hospital that he may sign. Where have you seen it, friend, in the Bible? It's your own doctrine. Tonight is your night. Repent and do it the Jesus way. He lavishes for the benefit of his bride. You haven't seen anything yet. The Americans say you ain't seen nothing yet. Let's keep studying the word of God in here. The city is 4 square. He measured 12,000 furlongs. If you have an NIV Bible, and the footnotes there, 12,000 furlongs is equal to 2,200 kilometers. Harare, Joburg. 2,200 kilometers long, 2,200 kilometers wide, 2,200 kilometers high. Perfect cube. And the king's messengers quoted from South Africa said, there is room enough for you. You know the king's messengers? My father loved them when I was a little boy, he used to play those songs. Don't stay away, brother. There is room enough for you. 2,200 by 2,200. Have you ever seen a seat like that on this earth? Well designed, a perfect square. And the Bible says, on the three gates, there are angels. Security guards, holy angels, six wings. Nothing that defiles shall enter the city. Thieves, adulterers, robbers, drunkards, they shall be cast into a lake of fire. They will not enter the city. The sexually unclean, the Bible says, outside the city, will you wait with the Son of Man? Will you enter the city? And John says, I will not keep reading. And he showed me the street of the city was not tar or tarmac. It was pure gold. Pure gold. As Jesus walks down the aisle, I saw him walking on a carpet like this. Carpet. Jesus walks with his bride on golden streets. And those that have loved him on this earth and given their lives to him will walk the streets of gold. Will you? The streets of gold, in English they say, as pure as gold. So for them to walk the streets of gold, they live lives on earth here by God's grace that are as pure as gold. So they qualify to walk the golden streets. So it says, the impure shall not enter the city. How can an impure person walk the golden streets? If you have lived an impure life before this night, thank God, he'll give you a second chance. Start walking in purity. Amen. Then you walk the street of God. No thieves up there. No gold partners up there. Unless they start digging the streets. Are you with me? The city does not need any light, because the glory of the light of the Lord is the light thereof. Jesus will light up his wife with his glory. Are you with me? He has prepared a city like this one. And I marvel at this, say, when Jesus takes us, when he comes, he has prepared this city. Amen. The foundation is laid up with several minerals. Jasper. Are you with me? Amethyst. There are 12 minerals. The tiles. Precious. Jesus just said, every bridge, my sister, represents you. You are precious to me. Oh, my amethyst. Oh, my beryl. What do you call your wife? Some call them honey. At least it's better. Some just say, you. You. They have no endearing language. Rough and dry. Some women are longing to hear loving titles. In words coming from their husbands, what do they hear? Commands. You. Oh, my amethyst. Every brick represents you, my gold. You are my jasper, my sister. Jesus tells the city, see what I've built for you. See what you mean for me. And the Bible says, then sisters, Jesus will take his bride to the streams of living water. Just one glass adds life, 1,000 years. Another glass, 1,000 years. Some guys have never taken their wife just for dinner. Our times are hard, you know. So stingy. I learned from Christ, my brother. How righteous thou? What says in the scriptures? And the Bible says in Revelation chapter 7, and they shall hunger no more. The lamb shall feed them. And the Bible says, he that does not take care of his own flesh is worse than a heathen. Yeah. Failing to feed your own wife. The men are angry. My friends. We are friends, eh? It's a man counseling men. And if Christ canceled all of us, how dare you spend on girlfriends? Rent me a flat. Buy me a sports car. You, Christ and the angels are looking at you. Friend, why should you go to hell instead of to enter the city four square? If any man has been spending in the wrong place, start spending on the right place.
Amen.
Take your wife out. Take your kids out. The Bible says, he shall lead them to fountains of living water. And he shall feed them. They shall not suffer from hunger. Can you see them walking together, Jesus in the church? Man, I will be there. I don't know about you. I will be there by God's grace. I don't know about you. As Christ takes us, come on, man, to the tree of life. Sweetie, pluck the fruit. And the tree of life bears 12 different types of fruit every month. That was the tree that was in Eden. Had God not removed it, Adam could have eaten it and lived forever as a sinner. If Adam had cancer and eaten that fruit, he would live eternally with the cancer here. Sometimes death is a blessing. But the tree he's going to lead us there. His wife, see them walking hand in hand, Christ and the church. Husbands, lovely wives, as Christ loves the church. Take her out. Even if she's 50, 60, 70, remember she was a girl. You have shared your life together. She's still beautiful. Take her out. Are you with me?
Amen.
When the youngsters see their father do that to their mother, they will do likewise.
Amen.
I don't know what example you are setting for your kids, Mr. Man. They are looking at you. If you have set a bad example, tonight is your night. Ask God for forgiveness. And ask God for a new page and do it the right way. Can you imagine Jesus beating the bride? Kicking her in heaven. Tender love. Friends, don't get out of the way. Those hands were made to love and hug your wife, not to punish her. Love is Christ's love. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible tells us we shall spend 1,000 years or the millennium. Honeymoon for 1,000 years. As the church enjoys that where I am, there you may be also. I'm so glad, man. Let me close with a great testimony of angels who witnessed this union. John says I heard a great shout from heaven, from the holy angels, Gabriel and his fellow brethren up there. Revelation 19 verse 7. It's our last text tonight. The mother of all weddings. As Christ comes in terrific majesty to receive his bride, the church. Amen. And the city is prepared for her. Amen. And you, if you believe, you'll be part of that church. And you have the right to look forward to his coming. As the angels witness this great mother of all weddings, John records here, Revelation 19, verse 7. Let us be glad and rejoice. These are the angels. Amen. Let us rejoice and be glad and give honor to him, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife has made herself ready. Did you hear that? The thousands and thousands and tens of thousands of holy angels say, let us be glad, for the marriage of the Lamb is come. Who is the Lamb?
Jesus.
Who is the wife?
The church.
Us here. Amen.
Amen.
If we choose to believe in Christ, the angels will rejoice. Remember, the angels rejoiced again when Jesus was born on earth. Joy to the world and peace, goodwill towards the sons of men. As the angels announced to the shepherds, this day the city of David is born, Christ the Lord. The same angels who sang Hosanna in the highest are yet to sing a louder note. There we shall hear celestial music, perfect voices, perfect tenor, bass, alto. My friend, as the angels sing and rejoice, and they also say, worthy, worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb who paid the bride price on Calvary. Today, he's waiting. His wife is here. Man will be introduced back in heaven. We shall see eye to eye with holy beings. Oh, my Father, we're told in the spirit of prophecy comments, we shall sit at the great welcome table. All of us will fit. It says the person who will be serving food that day is Jesus, starting with his bride. You take the bride, yes, I do. Give a piece of cake. Have you seen the meal? Now Jesus will be giving something to eat to everyone because he's you are precious in his sight. So imagine, friends, you've loved the pleasures of Joburg and you think you'll be missing. There's a chair that will be empty on the great welcome table. Lord, who's supposed to be seated there? They will tell us the name of the person who is to come and send you. Who wasted his time for 1 week here, hearing these words and never bothered? It says the person who sits at the end of the table, our eyes will be open and we'll see the person at the furthest corner. We shall see. When man sinned, he lost his eyesight. It became dimmed. He only sees three dimensions. But there are other things that exist beyond 3D. You know that? Yeah. Our eyes will open again. The Bible records that. The other day, the Assyrian armies surrounded Elisha. They wanted to attack him, and his servant said, "My Lord, you are finished here." And the prophet says, "Lord, open his eyes." When your eyes were open, you saw thousands of holy angels just nearby, and the Assyrian armies on the other side. We lost that spiritual vision in Eden. It will be restored. We shall see clearly. Thank God I will be there. I don't know about you. Are you with me? A 1,000 years, then we shall visit other planets. The Bible teaches that there are unfallen worlds. On a honeymoon, not in a hurry. For 1,000 years. Remember the book of Job? There came a day when the sons of God came to worship God. Those are the Adams of other planets that have never fallen. And the devil came there saying, "I represent earth." There are unfallen worlds somewhere. Amen. A good shepherd leaves 99 just sheep. He comes for one lost sheep, planet earth. There are just worlds up there. Jesus will take his wife. Come and see what I've created. The pre-Genesis creation. Come and see. We shall meet people there. Other Adams, other Eves of other worlds. We've been watching activities on earth with alarm. Watching the violence on earth, things on earth, prostitution on earth. They say, what has happened to the grandchildren of Adam? They will rejoice to see the grandchildren of Adam reintroduced back in heaven. Who told? But when the 1,000 years are expired, the Holy City comes down here. And those who never went for the wedding will be raised in the second resurrection for destruction. Never again to exist. And the Bible says, "Behold, I make a new heaven and a new earth, wherein dwelleth righteousness." Amen. How can I prepare to be in that city? Will you be there in that wedding? Mark 16:16 is what I leave with you. The bride must prepare. Jesus won't just prepare. Are you with me? The city alone. The groom must also prepare. Are you with me? Let us rejoice. Because the marriage of the Lamb is come. And his wife has made herself ready. The Bible says she has made herself. As Jesus is preparing the city, the wife, the church is preparing for the day. So we are in a preparation phase. As he prepares up there, let's prepare our hearts, prepare our relationship with him. Let's repent from every sin. That's part of the preparation. Amen.
Amen.
Mark 16:16, please. Anybody has opened it? I didn't type it. I know it by head. I want you to read for me. How can I prepare? The groom prepares, the bride prepares in this life, right? But in the spiritual arena, Jesus went to prepare. What preparation should we be making here? Mark 16:16. And if anybody finds it, please, I'll give you the mic to read. That's our last scripture. The great preparation. Sister, you can read for me.
"And he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be condemned.
Thank you very much. Let me hear from the man.
He who believes and is baptized. 16:16. He who believes and is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be condemned.
Hear the preparation? He who believes in Jesus, that he paid the price of Calvary for me, and he believes that Jesus has gone up to prepare a mansion for him, and he believes that Jesus said, I'll come back and receive you to myself. Amen?
Amen.
He that believes and is baptized shall be saved. Simple. You don't need a long profile. You don't need a university degree to enter there. Do you believe that Jesus paid the price for you? For all your sins, that you be forgiven, that you be counted righteous. Do you believe that? You don't need to pay or deposit R1 million. Do you believe that? Do you believe that he's going to prepare a place for you, that you are his jasper, his amethyst, you are precious in his sight? If you do, do you believe that he's coming again? Whoever believes and is baptized in the name of Jesus will be saved. But he that does not believe will be condemned. If you don't believe, you say, he never paid the price for me, he never died on Calvary for me, and he's never going to prepare anything for me, and he's not coming up, I will live anyhow. Those who believe don't live anyhow, eat anyhow, sleep anyhow. They are preparing to meet him. Amen. Tonight, I want to make a special call. It's the last night. What is it? Can I warn you tonight? If you come tomorrow night, you will preach yourself here. This is the last night. Amen. Jesus is coming back again for you. If you miss his coming and you are lost, it's nobody's fault but yours. Tonight, I want to ask the men who have come this whole, men who are here, God wants you to love your wife as he loves the church. That's your standard, full stop. I want to tell all the women here, God wants you to prepare. Wives, submit your husbands as the church submits to Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Full stop. That's your standard. Young people, are you there? Don't go about breaking hearts, breaking promises. Your model is Jesus in courtship. Pay Lobola. Pay the bride price. Go and prepare for her. Call witnesses. A minister of the gospel must be there to pronounce the blessing. Full stop. You have seen the model? Young ladies, don't give yourself too cheaply. Before you give yourself to him, he must pay. He must fear God. There must be witnesses. Are you listening? He that hath ears to hear, let him hear. Tonight I want to say, anybody say, Lord, don't end this week of prayer without blessing me as a man, without blessing me as a woman, without blessing me as a young person, without blessing me as a single parent, as a widow. I want you to see your hand up, please. The week of prayer ends tomorrow morning with a mighty prayer meeting at 8 o'clock. God bless your hands. He sees those hands. I want to pray. But before I pray, somebody says, Lord, I have to be baptized. I have to be in the city. Whoever does not believe and is not baptized will be condemned. Amen?
Amen.
I have to be baptized. All my sins washed away. Somebody says, Lord, I need a rebaptism. I am gone astray, Lord. Thank you for tonight. I understand you need me there. I'm precious to you. Lord, I'm coming home. As my pianist plays softly, I know Jesus is here tonight with his angels. And I want to say, Lord Jesus, I preach the word you sent me from Zimbabwe to teach here. Lord, I hand over the people to you. May your angels help your people to come up. Those who have received your word through the Spirit. And the Spirit speaks to your conscience, convicts you. Do you need to be baptized in the name of Jesus? That your sins be washed away. Your mistakes be washed away. That you need a baptism or rebaptism. Can I see your hand tonight? Thank God. God bless you. Don't look at anybody. There's a conviction in you. Your heart is telling you you have to do it. Are you there? Raise your hand, please. Jesus is so pleased. Are you there somewhere? I need to be baptized or rebaptized in the name of Jesus. Jesus said to Nicodemus, except you are born of water, baptism, and by the Spirit, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. You will not. Anybody needs to be baptized or rebaptized? Hands up, please. I see hands up. Can I ask you to come in here with me? I'm just going to pray a special prayer for those who want to be baptized. Those who just need a simple revival, you stay where you are. You can join them as they come. My pianist will be. We want to conclude this on a high note. Follow your hands by coming up, please. You can join them if your conviction is taking place. Your conscience is telling you this is the night. Don't miss the night. Follow your hand, come up, please. I want to be baptized or to be rebaptized. I want renewal in my life. God bless. The church is so quiet here. Amen. There is joy in heaven when one soul decides. Amen. Who else is coming? Join them. Come up, sister. Anybody else? When we give a special prayer and your heart tells you, God bless you, sister. If you are ashamed of me before people, I will be ashamed of you before my Father. Anybody else coming? We're now praying. I want to say to that man or woman, if you are shy to come up now, there was an old man called Nicodemus. He came by night. You can do it, Nicodemus, you alright? As people are going out, Nicodemus, they come and see us in the back. Are you with me? We are praying. Our Father who art in the kingdom of heaven, we salute you tonight in the name of Jesus. We are so astounded by the deep things of God contained in the Bible. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for paying the price on Calvary. For paying the bride price with your life. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for setting us an example of how it is done. Thank you for going up to prepare a place for us, a city four square. Thank you for your faithfulness. You left a promise that you are coming again. Thank you for Saturn Church, Lord. It is your bride. As you prepare a city up there, you want Central to prepare their hearts and their characters, youth and old people together, single parents and widows, and our visitors here. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because it is your desire that we should be where you are. And John said, even so, come quickly, Lord Jesus. We can't take it anymore in this world, Lord. Have mercy upon us. Remember your bride in the four corners of the earth, the remnant church. I want to thank you for my brother and my sister here tonight, who have responded to the payment you made on Calvary. And they say, sure, he bought us with his life. And they are saying we are no longer withholding ourselves, but giving ourselves to him. Congratulations, Lord Jesus. You did not die in vain. Behold the sweat of thy brow. Behold the purchase of your blood. Forgive, Lord. Forget whatever mistakes these two have made. Bury their sins away from them. Cleanse them and make them brand new creatures. Give them a second chance. Write their names in the book of life. For those who have raised their hands, Lord, don't let this week of prayer go by without blessing each one of them. Give each one a testimony. Oh, Lord, we bless your name. Write our names, all of us, in the book of life. Keep us in the faith until that day. In Jesus' name, amen.